Hello everyone, welcome to new Tech Tip video. My name is Zeeshan and I'm Cloud Evangelist at DataNext Solutions. Our today's topic is running serverless applications in the cloud. What is serverless? Before we dive into it, let's understand what is serverless. So traditionally, we used to write a piece of software, for example. For example, this is a website or any functionality, a batch job. You need to actually deploy this batch job to some server where people can actually access, your users can actually access this code. What about thousands of users now want to access this code that you have written? And you need to basically add basically a couple of more machines to actually handle that load. Otherwise, this code, basically the server is sitting idle doing nothing. And so basically, it's kind of a waste of resources. What is the concept of serverless is, basically you write a piece of function or piece of code, your batch job, you actually deploy to the cloud, serverless service. And once somebody calls that, your function, your batch job, it only runs at that time and then it stops. It's actually the cloud service actually remove all the unnecessary resources and you only pay till the execution of your function. So for example, your function usually takes 10 seconds to execute. So you pay only for the 10 seconds of the duration. So you save money, plus the code is more manageable. It's doing only one thing, lightweight. And there are other benefits of using serverless we can talk about in some other video. So what are the common services you can use and how you can actually use serverless in the cloud? So I'm talking about here more about AWS service, but same concept could be applied to Google Cloud or Azure. So in AWS, we have a service called Lambda. And in Lambda, you can write code in whatever specific language you have skill set. For example, you can write in Node.js, Python, you can write in Java, you can write in Go, you can write in Ruby. All these languages are supported. You can write your functions here and deploy to AWS Lambda services. Some services, for example, some functionality in the specific languages don't have a specific support. So in that case, you have to actually create some kind of a container where you deploy all the dependency of your code and then bundle that into a container and deploy to Lambda services. So Lambda services allow you to write basically code in two specific ways. One is you can write directly code to the Lambda specifications. And other way is to actually write a code in a container and deploy that container to Lambda service. And there are two more services that AWS supports. One is called ECS, which is Elastic Container Services. And then EKS, which is Kubernetes Services. They provide functionality called Fargate. So they also provide you two options, but we are talking about serverless functionality. So Fargate is basically a serverless service for running your container services and Kubernetes services. And the code you deploy, the APIs you deploy on either of these services, if you enable the Fargate option, you pay only till the duration of you use those services. Otherwise, you don't have to run the containers all the time. And thus, it gives you a significant benefit over the cost savings. So hope you like this overview of running serverless application in the cloud. If you have any comments or questions, or if you want to learn anything else, let me know in the comments. I would be happy to discuss in the future videos. Thank you.